So let's look at what you're going to do in a little bit more detail. So remember that what you're writing is a random tester for a credit card transaction processing system. So the core of this random tester is going to be a function called generate, which is what you're going to implement. So generate is going to take two parameters. The first one is the prefix, which is going to correspond to the issuer identifier. And this is a sequence of digits which is given to you, which has to appear at the start of the credit card number that you generate. The second parameter is the length. That is to say, an integer parameter that determines the total length in digits of the credit card number that you're going to generate. So your job then is to construct a credit card number which has the given issuer identifier or prefix, has the required total length, has completely random integers in the middle here, and has a valid checksum digit that's computed using Luhns algorithm plus this little procedure for turning a Luhns checksum into a digit which makes an overall credit card number's checksum come out to be zero and therefore be valid. So let's just look at code quick. So what you're writing is a function called generate. It takes the prefix and the length. And so your code is going to go here. And so we might call it like this. We might say the prefix is 37, 25, 42. So this happens to be the prefix for a credit card that I have in my pocket and a 15-digit credit card number. And now you're going to create a valid credit card number with the required properties. To do this, you're probably going to want to implement a function called lunChecksum, which computes the checksum of a number. And this auxiliary function is lunValid, simply checks if the lunChecksum for a given input is zero. So what I'd like you to do is implement that now. And if you get totally stuck, and you'd like kind of a hint, there's something you can do, which is look up Luhns algorithm on Wikipedia. And the reason that's kind of cheating is because on this Wikipedia page for Luhns algorithm, they actually give you Python code that works. And so don't go there unless you actually want to see the real answer. Okay, so take a few minutes now, write the code, and what our API will do is use it to generate a number of credit cards and check if they're valid. If they're not valid, it'll tell you it'll give you some indication of what the problem is, and if they are valid, then it will tell you at the end, and you can move on to the solution. Before I let you go hack on this, I just want to give you a quick reminder about something that should save you some trouble. So in the discussion I did here about Luhns algorithm, I assumed that digits were numbered starting at 1. So for example, number 1 here is an odd numbered digit. This is digit number 2, which is an even numbered digit. Number 3 is odd, etc. Now on the other hand, Python strings are indexed starting at 0. So that's something you're going to have to watch out for, or else you're going to get a little off by one error in your code that makes it a pain to debug.